Hi everyone, it's Tina with TSR Creations. So today I am going to do the bloom technique and I'm going to be showing you how I mix up some of the primary elements, pigments. If you're interested, these are by Colourarte and they're beautiful art pigments that you have to mix. A lot of people use these with the bloom technique, but you can also use them for pouring. I do have a coupon code. It is TSR921. You can save yourself 20% off of any Colourarte order. So that's great. There'll be a link down in my description box for that. So I'm going to show you how I do the bloom pouring medium. Okay, so the bloom pouring medium is what I use is Behr 8300. It is a, let me get the cans right here. Interior exterior high gloss enamel, untinted. So this is number deep base 8300. This is what I use. As you can see, it is, where is my, oh, my spoon fell in there. It is like a creamy, thick, goopy texture, but this is your base for your pigments. Okay. Get a piece of paper towel. Anyway, so this is your base. Add it to that. You can put in either Joshana gloss varnish, okay, or polyacrylic. So either one will work. These are it's polyurethane water-based, as long as it's water-based. All right. So that is your pouring medium to your pigments. All right. So I'm going to show you how I mix up a tube paint and a couple of these. Today I'm using the set, and this is, I believe this is jelly beans. Did I just throw that out? Yes, these are jelly beans. This is the set called Jelly Beans by Primary Elements. So there is a Fairy Wings. There is Over the Moon. And I'm going to show you these pigments. This is Aquarius. This is Pineapple Crush, pretty yellow. And then I have a Sweet Tooth and a Green Juicy Pear. So we're going to do something fun and bright. After I show you how to mix these up, all right? So I just took a teaspoon. I'm gonna take maybe a teaspoon and a half of the deep base. And we're gonna put in, and this is Over the Moon. All right, and then when you order from Colourarte, they give you the little spoons. So you want to take in like a nice big chunk and we're going to mix it in slowly. Okay. And it transforms into these beautiful pigments. Okay. You see that? Turn this light on. I'm a mess today. So this is a pretty bluish, like periwinkle almost. Okay, and you can see it's pretty thick right now. So I'm gonna have to thin it out. You're gonna use, that's what the high gloss varnish does, okay? So let's, don't shake it. You get bubbles. This is a new bottle I just got. And we are going to pour a little bit in there. Stir it up. Still a little thick. So we'll add a little bit more. until you get to the consistency that you prefer. Now, with the blooms, things are thicker. That's probably still a little thick. Probably good. All right, so that's a really pretty color. Can you see that? All right, so that was one primary element, and that was called Over the Moon. So we're gonna, I'm just gonna make a little so I know what they all are. Okay, so that's good. I might want a little bit more. So that's one color. Let's do another one. Let's do this yellow. This is Pineapple Crush. Ooh. Hope everybody's doing well out there. And just mix it in slowly. I don't use yellows a lot, but I want something bright and cheery. I've been doing a lot of beach-related pours because that's what people buy in my area. I live near the beach. So, you know, you get kind of stuck in your routine, but I just want to do something a little different. Look at that one. All right. So now we're going to add the gloss varnish. But I'm going to show you how I do a tube paint. So this is Amsterdam Pearl Violet. Now, you still need to add in the base. Even though this is a paint, you still want to add in the base because you want all your pigments and your paints to be mixed the same way. So I'm going to add a scoop of that. Some of that. And this will probably need a little bit more varnish, obviously, because it's a thicker paint. And oh, this is Amsterdam. I'm sorry, I didn't even tell you what the color was. It is Pearl Violet. It's a color shift. And I might use this actually, I don't know, maybe not. I was thinking about using this as a swipe color, but I'm gonna make it as one of my colors first, and maybe I'll do it. If it's a swipe color, you don't need to do the pouring medium. You don't need to do the deep base. All right, and then I have some quinacridone by Gliden. So we're gonna do that one too. So nickel azo gold. So just a little bit. Cup, squirt of that. These paints are expensive. So the other colors I'm going to be using is this Pebbio Studio Acrylic, and this is Blue Black, and this is an iridescent as well. I'll mix this one up for you too. I'm going to mix up the rest of these pigments and do my cell activators, which I think I'm going to use a gold cell activator maybe, and a black, I believe. And they are the 3 parts floetrol, Australian floetrol, to 1 part paint. I have my bases mixed up. I have a white house paint and I have a black house paint mixed up. So I hope this part of the video has helped you answer any questions, if you had any. If you do have any more questions, give me a holler. I get back to you pretty quickly. And yeah, that's probably about it. All right, guys, here we go. Trying to wake up from a dream. It's harder than it seems. Birds are flying on.
Wish that I could stay in this moment forever, so I can hold you in my arms. I will carry you on my shoulders as long as I'm able. Scare the monsters under your bed. Deep in the
always in your head.